workshop, right? You talk about Internet of Things, but you're thinking a little ahead. You're thinking about satellite of things, right? Probably you don't want to connect to internet, you want to connect to satellite directly. That's a really, really good topic to choose. I should come in. So I'm sure to enable these things, and then I've seen this initiative presentation and the kind of initiation is taking to really trigger the innovation in the hardware. So anybody can use software, right? Like anybody can cook, anybody can use software. But hardware requires a lot of passion and a lot of it's more solution oriented, right? Technology can be universal, right? People make chips, people make fans, people make aerodynamics, people make sensors, but solution has to be very local, right? You need to take all those technology things and make them as local things. So I'm really excited for really promoting this year to the ESG. Of course, Dr. Natarajan, I think you'll be hearing him in the next session. And for part of the short interaction what I had with him and knowing about him, he will get a lot of inspiration from what he already achieved in life. And just coming back to the program, actually I heard very nice narration of Kumar, that's the best salvation. It just doesn't require any satellites, just directly goes to God, right? That's a very, very good rendition of this thing in this part of the program. The other thing I was actually looking at is I never had this kind of felicitations kind of thing. Best role play you can do in a college is being a student, right? That's the best thing to do. And I wish I had time to sit with you people for the next 2 days, do things with my hand, right? It's like 21 years. Keep doing things to someone else, but then you always feel like doing something with your hand, right? So I was so anxious to do things with my hand. I got a rainbow movement for my daughter, and then today we are making the best bags. So please keep in touch with your hand, and always try to do something with your hand. That's one thing. The second thing is just to get connected in terms of what we do versus what Mr. Sai Kishore asked me to basically convey in terms of why only IT, why not the other things you should look out, right? One is awareness, second thing is not knowing. So if anybody is thinking that this salaries in IT are more compared to the hardware, you're wrong. I pay the best salaries for my hardware based on my company. The connected device guys, they draw more salaries, almost double the salaries. Just not that you're not aware of it, right? And don't think that salary is not there. And one point of time, salary doesn't matter, right? You get huge salaries, but you don't go back home satisfied, right? You don't sleep saying that you achieved something for the day. So that's more important. It's not that you shouldn't do the idea like that. Now, just to give you context in terms of what is that we do, you know what? Why am I here, right? Is we do many things like any other services company does, but what we trying to do from last 15 years is, if you see, there is an edge of the network. Edge of the network means where your Ethernet cable used to end before, where your laptops or desktops. Now it has gone to your phones, your tablets. Now where else it is going? It is going to sensors. It is going to your refrigerator. It is going to your TV. The edge of the network is going more southbound, right? It probably will go to your bangles, right? Your watches, your Apple Watch, right? So that means it's going more south, edge of the network, and that's where we do. So we build devices which talk to the sensors and the whole hardware, and then, now that you have all these sensors, devices, what are they doing? Pumping a lot of the data about you, about the refrigerator, about the power consumption, about light, everything to the server. Right? The other side is cloud. So cloud gets so much of data. Someone has to make sense of the data. Right? Someone has to make sense of the data. How do you make sense of the data? For example, you know that how much you are exercising, right? Then you know how much you are fit, right? In America, the insurance companies have come up with some new schemes saying that any employee working out and burning more than 500 calories a day is going to get waiver for the premium what they are paying. Such a huge thing. How they are doing it? They are doing it using the smartphones. If you take your smartphones, whatever you are today developing next 2 days, it is all there in the smartphone. Literally, while you are building with your own hands tomorrow, what actually you are doing is, you are actually dropping your smartphone from your building, and you can measure all what you are measuring tomorrow and day after. It has a pressure sensor, it has an e-compass, it has an accelerometer, it has a gyrometer, it has everything. Right? And it has a smartphone. It is a mobile operating system there. So you get everything there. You just need to understand how the sensor, you need to feel the sensors, what's happening. Right? So we do, on the back-end side and south side, both devices, including solar and water side, I should say. Right? So that is very, very important. And then on the northbound, on the cloud and the analytics, making sense of the whole data coming. That's what we do. And what areas we do, it's more relevant here, right? What I'm proud of what InnoMind is doing today is we actually collaborated with one of the Orange County professors who makes medical tactile devices. What does it mean? He takes pressure as a sensor and finds out anomalies in the body, right? Anomalies in the body. Pressure sensor to find anomalies in the body. Can you just imagine, right? So, Dr. Jason, he invented it. So there is something called breast cancer, right? Which you see is never a life-threatening device before. Now, if you see, it's more life-threatening than any other cancer, right? And first thing is, we are not aware of it. We are not so aware of it that being educated, being developing all those things. I never asked my wife, can you go and then basically have your examination done? That's a real, I don't know, don't know stage, right? So we need to be aware of it. Now, why people don't do it? Because finding the anomalies has a huge social enabling procedure called mammography. If you go to mammography, it is not very easy because you need to put your between the sensors, you need to put your breast, and that is not very good procedure for any of the social inhibitory procedures, right? Now, it's very expensive. It exposes 70 x-rays for you. And Dr. Jason, what he developed is, you apply pressure on the soft tissue, any anomalies there, it actually puts your back, and you can actually find the anomalies, the cyst, which is less than 1 mm. And then, if you see how the growth over a period of 2 weeks to 4 weeks, you will know whether it is more hard, is it growing in one side, right? Based on that, determine whether it is a benign or it is malignant. It is more hard, it is growing slow, then it is basically supposed to be a cancer. Now, what we did is, we took that and put our 3G module into it, right? And it directly pumps this information from people examining it directly to the cloud, where the clinicians can look at it and examine it and find out these anomalies very early. Right? Now that is the kind of innovation happening. So when you are looking at sensors tomorrow, the same pressure sensor used for breast screening, you're actually going to use it to find out the pressure delta when you are dropping these things from the buildings. Right? So that is very crucial. So look at it and adopt it and think about what I can do. Dr. Ramesh wanted to trigger your brains, saying that, hey, if I tell them to make some resistor, make a circuit, make a bulb glow, you may not be excited. So what he initiated is, if someone can do like this, then you trigger your thoughts, saying that, hey, what else I can do by dropping it, right? The other thing that you need to understand is, there are drones coming in. And what I understand from the research is, in China itself, it will be amazing. This is very consumerish kind of an idea. How many people must be taking selfies? I think raise your hands. Everybody who does this, no, that should be more. Right? You're taking selfies, right? Now you put your hand and take a selfie. What? How much you can pull your hand? Do that, right? Now, drones are going to be used for selfies. That means every one of you in this room, you're going to have your own small drones and you just flash it over the air and take a picture. Right? You find that's going to happen. You know the market size of that? 200 million. Just can you imagine? 200 million. So just understand that if you start doing a drone with a string onto your mobile, onto your laptop, onto your tablet, just imagine the kind of an opportunity you got. Just think out of the box, right? Next 2 days is only just tickling in our brains, and you just need to explode off of that, right? You can't just go back and sleep and look at your textbooks and write exams. You need to think outside, right? Now, I don't know about small segments, but what I know is what is inside what you're going to want, right? When I talk about sensor, the other thing I talked about is streaming, right? What it is doing is actually streaming the information. Now the streaming of the information is you are capturing up in drops. But I'm telling you how you should think. What Scikit-Learn has done it, I want one of you guys in the next 6 months, with the help of your teachers, take a modem module, the 3G module, put it to that. While it is dropping, you will see actual results. While it is dropping, you will see a graphical representation of the video. Right? That's what you probably need to figure out those kind of things. So that's the kind of innovation what you need to do, right? Now, there are a lot of other things happening. I'm telling you, some of the areas which you need to figure out these things are happening is, the other important thing in the healthcare itself we are doing is, there is a PMET sensors. You all must be on piezoelectric sensors used in the ultrasound. Now, what they're doing is, each of the sensor, putting them as a kind of matrix called PMOS sensors. And then you will understand very deeply why there's the anomalies in the body, right? That's one of the things. The second thing is on the assets. Now, a lot of critical assets being tracked, right? Now, it's all virus world. We all go with virus, which is like your GPS, your Bluetooth, low energy, your Wi-Fi, your Zigbee, all these protocols, 6 LoWPAN. What everything will do. So Internet of Things is that any sensor is there, you have a protocol, and you want to connect it, just connect it. Right? So you need to think about those for there. Right? Any of these things, I'll be happy to chat with you guys, but I'm looking forward to really seeing you guys take it from here and then put your own thoughts to it. Right? So while closing it, I just wanted to tell you a recent video I've seen of Alibaba CEO, is one of the very successful CEOs, right? In the past, he worked in Yahoo. And he was telling the students like you, and what he said? He said that between 20 to 30 years, you should work for a small company, right? Because all you guys must be looking out for jobs next year. Work for a small company. Actually, big companies, there are too many things, right? And you will not be doing focused research things and you will not be exposed to regular business videos. In fact, what you do, you don't work for a company, work for a good boss, find a good manager, right? Who can mentor you, who can really understand what is your strengths, who can bring the best of you, right? That's what you need to do between 20 to 30. 30 to 40, you need to think whether you will work for yourself, whether you can be boss for yourself, right? Because that is where you are basically coming into a little bit of leadership skills. 40 to 50 are the focus because you've done a lot of things in 20 years. And then you need to make sure that don't cut thin across too many things. Just focus. That means if you want to do all these things, you need to plan for today, right? You cannot say that I will plan at 40 years, right? So first you 20 to 30, then 30 to 40, 40 to 50, right? Where you are focusing on certain things, what you do the best. 50 to 60, right? That's something which, the age which I'm going to be there next year, what it says is, you should work for young people, right? I'm hopeful that all you guys will be successful.